Hello, 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 and happy Sunday to all of my Scorpios, my Scorpions. Yes, the I desire sign. Let's get right into your general reading. Yes, this is a general reading, and it's a timeless one. So whenever you see this video is when you're supposed to see it. The message is for you. So just take what resonates with you. Only take what resonates with you. Again, happy Sunday to each and every one of you all Scorpios. Let's get into it. Let's get into it. Let's see what these cards have to say. Let's see what messages are coming through, Scorpios. Yes, let's see which messages are coming through. Okay. Oh, very nice. Nice card. All right. Let's see. Okay. There was a trade-off here. There was a trade-off, which is very nice. It seemed like it was an intense one, but nevertheless, it was a trade-off. Here we have the Four of Wands. We had the Two of Wands. Somebody was doing something with the Aries, Leo, or a Sagittarius. We have the Three of Wands. And we have the Eight of Cups. We have the Eight of Wands. And we have the Queen of Cups. Oh my gosh. Okay. All right. All right, Scorpios. What is going on? I already know. All right. So somebody feels like they were burned by Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius, right? So this person, you know, emotionally they burned you, right? I'm not trying to put anybody in victim mode. I'm only telling you what I'm seeing in the cards, right? But when you walked away from that energy and you stepped into your own light, you know, here's the thing. Here's what helped you step into your own light, Scorpios. You all are a very focused, very brave, very passionate, very faithful, very ambitious side. Because you're a fixed sign, you could have become fixated on this thing, right? And so the person or persons, and it doesn't mean that their sun sign is Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. It could be, but it could also be their moon, rising, Venus, or somewhere else in their chart. They had to burn you hot enough for you to finally step into your own light. So there was a purpose in all of this, right? For somebody that's like, I didn't see the purpose. Like, they just burned me and whatever. Again, they put some kind of fire up under you. But here's your compassion. For you. So this is, okay, I'm going to tell you both sides of this, what I'm seeing with the messages that are coming through. Your compassion really allowed you to see all sides of this energy that burned you. You know, like you could even be in a good relationship with an Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. You could even be married to them, but somebody who burned you could have been the same sign, but their placements could be different, right? Like, let's say, for instance, their sun sign is a Sagittarius, but their moon sign, the person who burned you and hurt you, could be a Cancer, Pisces, a Scorpio, fellow Scorpion, you know, moon sign. The person who helped you could have been a totally different moon, rising, Venus. You know what I'm saying, Scorpios? But nevertheless, I see you stepping into your own light either way. Either you were burned or you were enlightened. But nevertheless, you stepped into your own light. So this, maybe listen, and I'm only the Aries, Sagittarius, or Leo that enlightened you or helped you on your journey. You feel like, okay, I feel alive. I feel great. I feel free. They may have encouraged you, like, don't take everything to heart. Like, don't take it so deep. Like, everything is not that serious, right? But your message also came through somebody who burned you. Like, I put way too much into this. Like, why was I so intensely attracted or, you know, to that energy? I just put way too much into it. And every single time, they actually ended up burning me, right? So, I'm getting somebody could be married to or in a current relationship or was in a relationship with the exact same sign, but it was the opposite experience. Yeah, that's what I'm seeing. Like I said, just take what resonates with you, right? So as somebody is moving on from a relationship, emotionally moving on from a relationship, I see somebody expecting bigger things to come as a result of that. Like, you're not stuck on, you're not fixated on this. It's like making you seem like you're possessive or dominating or domineering or jealous. You're not saying fixated on the emotion, right? Instead, you're expecting greater things to come. This person is kind of sort of standing on the edge of something, like about to take a leap of faith. they have this fire inside of them, like this divine masculine energy is like really firing them up, encouraging them. Like even if it was a bad situation with a person where you felt like burning them, they may have said something to you to put a fire up under you. Maybe they said something like, you know, I don't trust you because you're so secretive or whatever. They may have put a fire up under you to sit there and listen to yourself. And this is just an example, right? They may have put a fire up under you that says, you know what? Maybe I don't need to be so secretive. Maybe I need to tap into my gifts. Remember, water signs, you all are very intuitive. All of you. Cancer, Pisces, and Scorpio, very intuitive, right? And maybe that energy puts some fire up under you to say, you know, listen to your intuition. Just listen to your intuition, right? But I'm seeing tons of opportunities come across your path, and I see them coming across your path fast, like quick progression. Where's the card? This right here, the Eight of Wands. Things are coming, tons of opportunities are coming across your path because you're tapped into that divine masculine energy, right? You're severing ties with emotion. I mean, like firing, burning a bridge, like I'm never going back to that again. Not because I'm bitter. No, because actually I'm better, right? I'm never going back to certain energies, right? I'm not going back to certain emotions attached to it. I'm kind of like seeing somebody's mother transition, like somebody's mother died and you didn't have the best, somebody didn't have the best relationship with their mom. And now that you're making peace, somebody has forgiven something, but you all are making peace with it. And now it's like opening up opportunities for you a lot quicker. You know, somebody may have been, part of the reason why somebody was coming on so strong is because they were looking for some nurturing, like from their own mother, and they weren't getting it. But now that you've made peace with it, where's the card? Now that you've made peace with something and you're moving on from it, I see like a lot of opportunities coming your way, advancement at work. I'm saying you meeting new people, like soul tribes or possibly romantic relationships. Is that what you want? I see you spinning the globe and pretty much going wherever you want. Sagittarius, Scorpio. Because again, this represents fire signs. So somebody could have been in a relationship with a Sagittarius, Aries, or Leo, like I said. But somebody put some kind of a fire up under you. Like somebody, whether you saw it as a good or bad thing, like whether you saw it as them burning you or enlightening you, it kind of inspired, it kind of put the spark up under you that you needed to move, like move beyond something emotionally. Yeah. And I see you celebrating outside of your house, right? Outside of your spiritual house, outside of your physical house. I see, or inside your spiritual house, I see you celebrating like, okay, finally, I had to make peace with whatever that thing was. Like, I had to forgive that person. It doesn't mean that I'm going to forget, but I forgive that person. That's what I'm saying for you. I forgive somebody. Somebody I forgive. Yeah. And also thanking the person that put fire up under you. Yep. Mm-hmm. Yep. All right, here we have the Ten of Wands, which is more fire. I see somebody physically moving, like maybe moving into a new house and celebrating outside of their house. Well, congratulations to you, Scorpios. I'm also seeing the Page of Cups. Somebody from your past is not only thinking about you. So if you start to think about, like, if you think about an ex or ex-friend, ex-lover, ex-whomever, and it's draining your energy, now you know it's time, even if you're physically not, because it looks like you're not physically going back to that energy. But if it's an energy leak for you, you need to sever ties with it, including if they said something to you to hurt you real deep, whether that person is still alive or they're not. Again, it's time to sever ties with it because you're about to enter into a new cycle and you don't want to take that emotion into a new cycle, right? I see this being replaced with the things that you're releasing. So now you have room to receive more money. So congratulations. Again, like I said, somebody receiving some more money at work. Somebody has enough money to buy a house or move into a new apartment or whatever it is. But I see you celebrating outside of something, right? Again, somebody felt like, like I said, there's multiple scenarios looking at your cards. Somebody has gone through this Ten of Swords energy where you felt betrayed, backstabbed, talked about, all these hurtful things, right? Like I said, burn, left for dead, emotionally, spiritually. But this number 10 right here lets me know that you can instantly manifest whatever it is you want your future, to your now and your future to look like. So now it's time to start listening to the guidance of your ancestors. Like you may go outside and see a lot of birds flying around. Your ancestors are like, we got you. We all around you. You're not by yourself, right? Here we have the justice card, right? So if you have court, justice is in your favor. Somebody don't need to even overthink it. Somebody has literally been worrying themselves to just frustration, like a headache that you've been overthinking. You don't need to overthinking it. You don't need to overthink this, right? You need to focus on your internal peace and happiness. If you don't have a court date, you got a sword and you want to focus on things that you love to do, like nurturing yourselves. I'm seeing somebody being near a body of water because that's what you love to do. So that's going to take that sword and sever things out that don't serve your highest purpose. So again, it's like, I'm not overthinking this, the fact that this person hurt me or burned me. I'm not trying to get over it. I'm healing through it. That's what I'm seeing for somebody. And so now that's when the new opportunities are going to come your way because somebody is healing through some stuff. Here we have the Hierophant card, which is trying to jump out of the deck. So this is letting me know that somebody is taking their rightful place on the throne. Your thoughts are a lot more organized. You're learning how to be more patient with certain things. You know, somebody is rooted and grounded. Somebody is ready to, you know, step into the life that they reserve, right? Like really enjoy this earth through good friends and good relationships with people as well as your money. So again, I do see somebody celebrating. Or you could have severed ties with a Taurus. Somebody could have severed ties with somebody who had Taurus in their chart. But again, nevertheless, what I'm seeing for you all, Scorpios, is again, because you all are allowing, because you're an emotional sign, that's you, Cancer and Pisces, you all are water signs, that represents your emotions and creativity and your intimacy. Somebody could have severed ties with somebody who had Taurus in their chart, where it could have. And even if their sun sign is not Taurus, somebody say, no, that person was a this sign or they was that sign. They weren't. I need you all to focus, like really listen to what I'm saying is they could have Taurus in their chart. It could be their moon, rising, Venus or whatever. You don't need to go pull up their full birth chart. But what I'm saying to you is that their energy was almost threatening your money and threatening your relationships. Okay. Their energy was threatening your, and so as you sever ties with them, now you're creating space for, and it was real dark and it was real intense. Like they weren't trying to budge who they are. You weren't trying to budge who you are because both of y'all may be fixed energies. But again, so you had to take the initiative to sever ties, and that's when you started seeing more things come across your path. So it was an emotion that you were severing ties with, really, right? Don't let pride get in your way. Leo, another fixed energy, right? Don't let pride get in your way. Sever ties with that thing and move on. The emotions attached to it so that you can start enjoying the fruits of your journey. I mean, like really, like this spiritual journey that you've been on. So I do see more money coming across your path, but I do see somebody almost feeling like they're by themselves in this. And you're not. Your ancestors, like I said, are right here. They're right here. They're like trying to guide you through this process. Wisdom isn't something you learn. It's something you become. Mm-hmm. Very nice. And then we have, I am becoming wisdom. I love it. Love it. Love it. I am becoming wisdom. That's right. Age does not equate to wisdom. So whenever you can't assume that somebody younger than you are is not wise, or somebody's older than you are wiser than you are, that no, because age doesn't equate to wisdom. But again, let's keep it moving. Let's keep it moving. Let's pull another card for you, Scorpio, to see what else we have here. Alone time. I do see somebody spending some time near water. I see some jet skis. I see a boat. I see somebody stretched out on the beach, sunbathing, you know, but nevertheless, I do see you near a body of water. Just coming to terms with something and saying, hey, listen, somebody is even asking, how can two people be the same sign? But this one hurt me and like constantly hurt me, brutally honest. And they just say stuff like cuts like a knife or like a blowtorch, while this one can be so loving and kind. Here's the thing. Everybody has their higher self and their lower self. The higher self is God in us, our intuition, you know, a source. Our lower self is the flesh. So everybody has good in them. Everybody has evil, seen, unseen, known, unknown. Because some of you all may be saying like, I dealt with this sign and I never saw the worst come out of them because it's all a choice. Or I dealt with this sign and they consistently chose their lower self. Again, it's a choice, right? It's a choice. So again, I do see forgiveness. I don't see that you're forgetting anything. You don't need to forget anything. All you need to know is if I'm walking away, I'm walking away for good. And I'm listening to my intuition from now on. So you all are the best sign at your rebirth, right? So when you're leaving a situation, you're leaving the situation behind permanently, emotionally and physically, right? So that's what I have for you, Scorpios. I will see you in a couple of days. Bye.